Generally, when we talk about months, we talk about solar months. We are mostly familiar with it. But there also is a different kind of month called lunar months. The lunar month is common among astronomers and sky watchers. There are many types of lunar months. But in this video, we are only going to look at sidereal and synodic lunar months and see what they are. Let's start with the sidereal month. Please note that this diagram is not to scale and proportions, but it will do for an easy and clear explanation. Now, sidereal month simply is the time taken by the moon to go around the earth once, that is to travel 360 degrees. Let's mark the initial position of the moon with this dot. Now, let's track how many days the moon takes to go around the earth and return to the same position. We see that it takes about 27.322 days, which is 27 days, 7 hours, 43 minutes. This duration is called the sidereal month. Now, let's see what a synodic month is. For that, we need to see a bigger picture and we have to consider all three, the sun, the earth, and the moon. Let's start when the moon is aligned with the earth and sun on this line. This alignment of the earth, sun and the moon occurs on the new moon day where the moon is in between sun and earth. Let's again mark the current position of the moon with this dot and keep track of the time as the moon goes around the earth. As the moon goes around the earth, notice that the earth is not stationary and it is also going around the sun. Now, like before, we see that moon has taken 27.322 days to go one complete revolution around the earth and return to the dot. But we can see that because the earth was also moving in its orbit, the moon is no longer aligned with the earth and the sun. It has to travel further to reach the alignment, that is for it to be a new moon day again. To do this, it needs roughly about 2 more days. So, we observe that to go from one new moon day to the next new moon day, the moon takes around 29.53 days or 29 days, 12 hours, 44 minutes. This is called a synodic month. We can also see this if we look at the moon and track the phases. Let's start with a new moon day and track the time it takes for the moon to reach the next new moon. We again see that it takes 29.53 days to complete the cycle. Hence, we saw what sidereal and synodic months are and how their duration differs. Thank you for watching. We hope this video helped you. Please consider subscribing to our channel if it did.